Philadelphia. We're over in New York, not very far. The best juice isn't shipped. It always comes in fresh. We're going to see him play fresh against the Buzz here in Game 1, Battlefield.
Yeah, we'll see how this works out. The matchup of Zero Suit Samus versus Olimar. So this is actually a matchup that the Buzz is probably it's a little bit fresher in his mind. He's played countless sets against Mars, both this last season and also one last weekend at Low Tier City 7, where the Buzz came out on top. So we shall see if Juice can bring anything different to the table here.
Mm-hmm. Now, one thing about this matchup that I think is interesting, right? Right off the bat, having not seen a whole bunch of it, oh, geez, that nearly killed a man, is that Zero Suit has typically two types of moves. A move that is active for a really long time with a lot of hitboxes, or it's out for a split second, and then she auto-cancels it. One of those is really good for dealing with Pikmin. One of those is really good for keeping active while Pikmin are on you. But it's one or the other. You have to commit to them. There's no like middle ground where you can go like, oh yeah, I'll just do this move that's good at keeping Pikmin off and I'm not super vulnerable the
right.
entire time.
I think the advantage that Zero Suit has in this matchup is, and Juice is doing a good job displaying it, is that he's able to keep Olimar at a certain range to where even if he's able to keep the Pikmin hits at bay, and even if he does get hit, he's at least like minimizing, mitigating his damage from the range that he's at. Mm-hmm. But right now, both players sitting at a super high percent.
Ooh.
And oh, the lone
snipes
Pikmin.
Him with the purple Pikmin.
Yeah, that'll take the stock 10 times out of 10.
Yes. So for those who don't know, the Pikmin order goes, I believe it's red, blue, yellow.
Red, blue, yellow.
White, purple.
White, purple.
So
yes.
How that works is that the purple Pikmin are the only one that don't attach to the opponent and work like standard projectiles. They're also the heaviest hitting out of all of them. If you see a purple Pikmin, they're the heaviest, so they don't recover very well with Olimar. You'll see Olimar's toss purple Pikmins when they're trying to recover sometimes. But they'll also use that for their smash attacks if they want to toss and cover off stage. Just like he's got right there.
And this is exactly the scary part, in my opinion, about fighting Olimar. And I've heard other players like Mars say this, as the Plasma Whip gets the job done. You have such little time to adapt to what Olimar's game plan is, because look at how quickly the damage latches up. A lot of that being added on by White Pikmin. White Pikmin doing the most latch damage out of all of the Pikmin in Olimar's arsenal. So,
Is White the one that has the most grab range, or is that Blue?
That's Blue. Blue has the most grab range, and it has the strongest throws.
Yes, that's correct. And then Red, of course, has the fire effect on it, so it does a little bit of extra damage. And then Yellow has the lightning effect, really good for knockouts. Like I think we just saw right there. I heard the lightning effect.
I believe we did. So, all right. So right now, the Buzz just putting on a clinic right now. And again, the damage has come so quickly and uncontrollably against Olimar. The Juice really has to, either secure an early kill at some point or, figure something out in the range that he has to play at.
Mm-hmm.
That's one way to do it, though.
He's sitting a stock behind and he's trying to make it work, but Olimar's not about juice. Whether they're onions or carrots, he's about those vegetables. He wants you to get your vitamins.
Yeah, now
see him in game two.
Yeah, and that was, I just think, a very obvious like recovery attempt from Juice. The Buzz just was in really good position to catch that, and Juice just trying to jump above the ledge to go for maybe a more aggressive landing option, and the Buzz is going to call it out 10 times out of 10 times.
Mm-hmm. Especially because Olimar, again, for those who aren't familiar, his aerials, his smash attacks, I believe some of his tilts, but I'm not 100% on that. Anything that uses the Pikmin, essentially, functions as a disjoint. The Pikmin are not attached to Olimar in any way. So if you go for something like, I'm going to jump up, I'm going to toss out a back air, you're not likely to get counter-hit by that.
Right.
You might waste your jumps, and you might give up your chance to trap at the ledge, which is a very strong area for a lot of characters, but you're not going to suffer the risk of trades, which is actually a really big deal against someone like Zero Suit, who has really strong trades in her back air. Her Nair is really good because you can trade combo off of that. So that's a difficult thing to lose out on in a matchup like this.
Like I said, you just have to adapt. So you have to adjust your game so quickly against Olimar when things aren't working out that just, sometimes it works out for you, sometimes it doesn't. And Zero Suit Samus is a character that she's not the explosive, expensive sports car she was in Smash 4. She's much more like a Honda Accord. It's nothing super flashy, but it's enough to get the job done. She's become much more of a complete character. Mm-hmm. So, there isn't that insane comeback factor that Zero Suit Samus has. So, we'll see if Juice can make the adjustments.
Yep, and he's getting a lot of mileage out of the stage control right now, but let's see if he can keep that or if he's going to have to park in the station sometime soon.
Yeah, and the center platform is going to be huge for both the Buzz and Juice. Whoever can set up camp under the platform the longest, probably going to find themselves in prime position moving forward.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. You actually see Juice duck under the buzz there and resume stage control. Tries to go off hard to get something off of it.
He had like a flip jump, almost spelling death for Juice right there, but you know, just out of range for the buzz to not get too crazy of a punish.
Yep. Actually,
what?
So, yo, wait.
Did that trip?
That did trip. That was just her plasma whip, yeah? I've never seen that.
That was crazy. Then up throw gets the job done.
Yeah, get him off the top, do an up smash for good measure. Let him know.
There you go.
All right. Picking his Pikmin. Oh, yo, so you saw it. Now, if that was a couple frames earlier from Juice's grab, he might have actually beaten that out, but the disjoint just heated him raw, and the Buzz is sitting safe back over behind his boys.
Yeah, and the Buzz already, you know, setting up shop with those low percent up smash. The door stops coming up from the Pikmin, because those obviously combo into each other at those low percent, and the damage, depending on the Pikmin lineup, he adds at his arsenal, could be very, very scary.
Mm-hmm. Actually does a neutral get up, gets past that, I don't know what to call
the
plasma.
The paralyzer, that's right,
the paralyzer. Paralyzer shot.
All right. Yeah, Juice actually hasn't been utilizing that a lot. That's a, you'll probably see more in like ledge situations where he might try to hold it a little longer to time it on the Buzz's get up. So we'll see if that becomes a factor later.
Yes, another thing to consider is that Pikmin do in some sort of sense function as mini Lumas. They will block paralyzer shots for you. Those boys will die for their captain.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nice. Chases off stage. He's been looking for that Zero off stage. Finally gets it.
Oh,
there's the
mercy.
Spike.
Yeah, Juice showing no regard for human life right there. or Pikmin life. So,
what is Olimar, really?
He's a hardworking spaceman that's trying to make money for his wife and kids.
Man, poor guy's been tossed into this freaking galaxy bounty hunter over here. It's like, man, I just want to make money for my kids. I picked sentient vegetables for a living. I'm also a murderer on the side, but don't tell nobody. Now in the last stock for both players.
Oh, man. All right, so this is, if there's ever a chance for Juice to strike, it's here, man. Like, we'll see if he has enough gas in the tank to finish this out, or if the Buzz will go up 2-0. But right now, the Pikmin lineup right now, very, very strong. And great call out on the shield from the Buzz.
You know what they say about Honda Accords? They got good mileage! They got good mileage! 1-1.
Goodbye, sir, as Juice knocks everything up at 1. And like I was just saying, Gretch, that's huge for Juice, because the complexion of a set completely changes if you go into it 2-0. Mm-hmm. If you go down into it down 2-0 versus tied up at 1-1.
Look at that man. He's centering himself. He's ready. He's staying hydrated.
Yep, King Miles sitting on his throne right now.
Crowd yelling chug. Well, player 4 yelling
hey,
chug.
Hey, hey,
hey.
Yeah!
That's okay, man.
Yeah, oh.
Oh, there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, let's get that instant replay. Ladies and gentlemen at home, take this time now. Get up, get a glass of water, stay hydrated. It's hot out there. Water's good for you. Water tastes good. Get that tap, get that filtered water, get that Dasani, Poland Spring, whatever you enjoy. Drink up.
Only the most quality content here on House of 2000. Here we go, folks. Game 3 between the Buzz and Juice. Going to Battlefield. Again, so the Buzz won on the stage in the first game. I feel like the triplat lineup, depending on, because the problem for Juice in the first game is that he was doing a lot of jumping like parallel to the stage, which
yes,
the Buzz was starting to catch on to a lot near the end.
Ooh,
of that
first drop down with the down air, that was really smart.
Oh yeah, and that move has like a very deceptive amount of end lag on it. Like it's not as laggy as you think. It would be compared to other down airs?
Yes. Not only that, but how he did that. Because it's a stall and fall, he was actually right in the middle of the platform and made it really ambiguous whether or not he would go down through. So made it seem like it wasn't an option at that point.
They see the Buzz opting to kick it back and throw a lot more Pikmin. That dash grab gonna help Juice regain stage control. Going for something gnarly.
Ooh,
with
the
boost
school.
Kick.
Okay. Yep, boost kicking back. Keeping neutral, not trying to engage too hard. Yo, that landing, Zare, what was that?
Ooh. In the words of my friend Hazmat, that is the, I swear this doesn't usually happen to me. So, regardless, the Buzz living that boost kick to see another day, and now both players sitting at this very scary percent, and the Buzz has a very potent offensive lineup right now as the purple Pikmin seals out the stock for the Buzz.
All right. Nice parry. See, that's a difficult situation in that. ZSS doesn't really have any quick upwards options out of a parry to deal with a multi-hit like
her that. Her best option is up B, but like I said, it's a multi-hit. He multi-hit you should probably try to parry that near the end and slot not at the beginning. There you go, forward air though.
Yep, forward air. Yo, he's sitting on 60% though. He was just eating Pikmin that whole time.
Yeah. Like I said, man, that's how things can kind of get away from you if you're not paying attention. Look at that,
yes,
already 120.
He doubled the percent, man. He doubled his dose of Pikmin in less than 10 seconds.
Yeah, math is hard.
Math is very hard, although DaBuzz, no stranger to numbers here. He's keeping a good job on the Pikmin and keeping Juice's number. Doesn't even get any percent on this stock. He just took, like, what, 6?
No, sir. Yeah.
3%?
Yeah, like, that was such a like, DaBuzz's Pikmin lineups have been very formidable, but the combination of purple, yellow, and white just proved to be very, very rough for Juice on that stock, and he's just kind of running away with this game right now.
Yes.
Jeez.
It's going to be quite difficult for this to come back for Juice right now. It's still possible. ZSS does have some comeback factor. She's got the spike. She's got the up B that does kill fairly early over at the ledge. And she does have the disjoints to contest with her throws and with her Zare here. But it's difficult when you're a stock behind like this, and Olimar is just pelting you with these purple Pikmin.
Yeah, Olimar is sitting pretty with the... I just pictured a Tom and Jerry meme with the two cats walking in through the door with their buff. That's what...
Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, he's got the bodyguards with him right now.
Oh,
although, gets him back off stage without a jump! Yo, very nice. Actually goes low, feints it a little bit, and then comes back up. Good recovery by DaBuzz's part. That could have spelled doom for his stock.
There you go, trying to break zone with the Zare right now. Ooh, ooh, but great tech on that forward air. That definitely would have spelled curtains for Juice if he didn't get that.
Although if he gets in a tech situation again, he's getting to that percent where he's going to hit the untechable. For those who don't know, if you get hit into the stage at a high enough speed, you cannot tech it.
There
you also can't tech those.
Yeah, as the dead stare of the purple Pikmin looks you right in the jaw as you go down 2-1 here.
Do the Pikmin get hurt when you toss them at things?
You know what? Don't ask questions you're not prepared to know the answer to.
That's perfectly fair. The real question is Juice hurting right now? Going into game 4, it's 2-1. This is his chance to come back here right now. He's proven that he can do it, but this is obviously a rough matchup right there. And as you've seen, DaBuzz plays patient. If you don't play patient back, if you don't take your time with that, you're just going to eat 60% out of nowhere, 120% out of nowhere, lose a stock out of nowhere.
Yep. Not only is it 2-1, but he got bodied that game.
he got smacked around a little
like,
bit.
I can't even sugarcoat it. Like DaBuzz kind of like put the... you know, beat the brakes off of him in that game. So Juice obviously kind of taking his time, thinking about his stage choices. DaBuzz smartly banning Smashville. He did not ban that in the second game, and that's where Juice put the hurt on DaBuzz.
Yep.
So we're going to see a potential different stage. Looks like we're going to Pokemon Stadium.
Mm-hmm. It looks like it. I can see from the counterpick tablet right there, courtesy of House of 3000. Devin is a tech wizard. Shout out to Devin 3000.
Yeah, House has something like, you know, Tri-State's great, but House in New York has some of the best production out of... any of the regions we want. Mm-hmm. Chef kiss. Mwah.
All right. So we're going to see Pokemon Stadium.
Yep, we shall see if Juice can send it to game 5 or if DaBuzz will punch his ticket to top 16.
Yeah, we will see. Now, granted, I think that Juice needs to shift gear in something here, but I'm not sure, honestly, what the game plan change would be. If you play too patient against Olimar, eventually you are going to catch Pikmin. That's just a fact of the matchup. If you play too aggressive, you're going to catch Pikmin and not realize you're sitting on 70%.
Yeah, so, that's just the thing. You just have to... He's not necessarily doing anything wrong, just DaBuzz is just doing a better job at... I think Juice's defensive options is what's kind of getting him killed a little bit. There we go.
Goes
Oh, no!
He might die for that. No, okay, gets back. DaBuzz going for it. Looked like a downer on that one, but doesn't get the follow-up. Ooh. That was a real jank-looking pivot throw on that one. Did you see that?
Yeah, that was wild, but there we go. Up air going to catch the landing as DaBuzz strikes first in this game 4.
Yep.
Ooh,
oh,
but Juice retaliating immediately.
Looking like a hit and run. He says, hey, get back here. We got to swap insurance. All right. Catches him with the Nair. Good chance to shark on the platform. Olimar actually still getting back. Oh, that's a big punish.
Yeah. Some things are, you know, just never change, man. Death taxes, ZSS getting punished after missing a grab. So
that's the thing. It is a very slow grab. And like I said, she either has very quick moves that are out for a split second, or she has long-ass multi-hit moves with really big recovery frames like this. So it's hard to deal with Pikmin and keep your offense going, or hard to maintain defense while not getting freedom by Pikmin.
Yeah.
You have to choose one or the other at any given time. Actually managing to get them with the tip of the grab, that's a good job.
And Juice is trying to play around the DaBuzz's shield right now and still taking a lot of tertiary damage from these Pikmin. The Buzz gets the parry, but just a little bit too slow on the draw as that F smash.
That's all right. It actually looked like Juice had jumped over that, which might have been a good reaction call for his.
Okay, so interesting that the Pikmin did not interact with the paralyzer shot right there. Like you said, they do such a great job body blocking. You know, just buying the Buzz a little bit of extra time. The Nuchilur are going to break zone, but again, just not a great, you know, just wasn't in a position to get a follow-up out of it, pretty much.
Fun fact, too, the Pikmin, the red, blue, oh, fun fact, Juice is on his winner's stock. But the Pikmin, the red, blue, or actually, I think it might just be the red and yellow. But the red and yellow, if you hit the red one with fire, it's not particularly effective.
Yes.
If you hit the yellow one with sparks, which coincidentally is what Paralyzer and a lot of other ZSS's moves has, it's not effective. So it will blow through,
yeah,
I'm pretty sure.
Yellow Pikmin confirmed plasma.
There
we go. But again, just the Buzz putting the hurt on Juice right now. He's having a hard time getting out of the corner.
Mm-hmm. And this is really what might seal the deal for him here, is that the Buzz doesn't need to play this aggressively. He can play back a little bit, toss some Pikmin, get some straight percent here or there, and then be cool with it. He's sitting up at a full stock right now, 64%.
Ooh.
Oh, he wanted to end it, though.
Close
Sigma
to it.
Two purple Pikmin. This is dangerous. Gets the air dodge out, tries to go for the down air. Oh, that's it.
Yeah, unfortunately, Juice running out of resources right there as we get claps as Liquid the Buzz staying hydrated and staying in winner's bracket, punching his ticket to top 16 winner's side. Juice, again, going to take a small dip into the loser side of things.
I still think that was a pretty strong showing, all things considered. Now, I have no idea what the matchup would be for that, because I don't see a whole lot of Olimar. I don't see a whole lot of ZSS. I know Mars is high profile. I know that DeBuzz is high profile.
Yes.
But rarely do I see these two interact. And I feel that
the Buzz and Mars definitely play a lot.
Yeah.